Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for another day in your sanctuary, Lord. Hallelujah. God bless the people that are on their way here, en route here. God bless everyone in social media. Hallelujah. God bless everyone who is present. Oh, God, may your anointing be on our praise and worship team, on our musicians, on all the ministers and speakers and solo singers. God, just bless us in the sanctuary this day in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, it's a good day. It's a good day. Hallelujah. It's a day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, I'm thinking about all the people that I was able to pray for and witness to, and the people that even that I witnessed to before come back and talk to me about they're still reading their Bibles. You know, I mean, if you're not witnessing, you know, you're missing out on something. Because that lifts me up when I think back on it. You know, when I get to thinking down and discouraged, I think about the people who the Lord blessed through me during the week. And that lifts me so high. Sometimes people I've been witnessing to come up and, Pastor Nana, they give me a hug. Last week, somebody, I said, somebody was having trouble. So I told him, I said, listen, I'm going to pray for you, and God is going to lift you up and make you feel better. You know? And I went back and I prayed. I said, Lord, I said, please, I said, show yourself real in their life. I know they're not saved right now, but you want people saved. I said, show yourself real and make her feel better in Jesus' name. And at the end of the day, she came up to me. She didn't say a word. She walked up with her eyes a little bit watery, with a big smile, and just gave me a big hug. Do you know how blessed that made me feel? You see, God, you know, I pray for everybody. I don't ask them, are they saved? I don't ask them what their sins are. They just tell me, they say, you know, I need you to pray for me. And sometimes they do the little Catholic thing when I pray for them. They do that cross thing. But see, I pray for everybody. I don't ask questions. I ask this Holy Spirit, what should I pray for them? That's all witnessing is being yourself in Jesus. You don't have to struggle with it. The devil come and tell you something, you tell him to shut up and you do what God tells you to do. Well, Pastor Stan, you just the pastor of evangelism, that's why you talk that way. No, I've been the pastor of evangelism since my first week I got saved. I do every bit of one or two scriptures, and I went to work quoting them. So just be yourself in Christ. And so now let's bow our head and close our eyes and bring the worship team and the praise team and the musicians. They're anointed. And may God bless them. God, we come to you in the name of Jesus. We pray that you bless this service. We pray that you bless everyone who is in attendance, whether it's in social media or in the sanctuary, that you bless them with the needs of their life, with the desires of their heart. And God, bless people with salvation, even in social media. We say a prayer for them at the end of the service. God, let them get saved. Hallelujah. And accept Jesus in their life, God, as you have done us here in this church. And so, God, we just pray your blessings upon everyone in Jesus' name. And God, thank you for our praise team and their obedience to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Let's give a hand to our praise team, our musicians. Hallelujah.
God bless you. God bless you, Pastor Stan. What an encouragement. Thank you. Hallelujah, somebody. Yeah. Hallelujah this morning. This morning, let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich.
Hallelujah.
Because Christ is risen. Hallelujah.
Rich.
We have come to honor him this morning. So I just want you to shake yourself up and give the Lord a praise and a worship that he deserves this morning. Don't look at your circumstance or where you're at. We're just looking to him,
yes,
who is the author and perfecter of our faith. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have come to say thank you. Can you just lift up your hands and give God some thanks this morning for the rain that comes down on both the weak and the strong, on both the believer and the unbeliever. We're saying thank you, Lord, for the sun that shines. Thank you, Jesus, for the food that you've given us. Thank you, Lord, for the shelter that we have. Lord, we bless you. We honor you. Take glory. Take honor. You are due. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, God. You are God all by yourself, and there is no one like you. We have come to praise you, King. God Almighty.
Champion, he reigns forevermore.
dead cannot praise you. So as long as we have breath, we will bless you at all times. Praise is what I do when I wanna be close to you. Just who I am.
find the 24 elders. The Bible says they bow down and lay their crowns before the Elohim. Adonai, flashes of light, we worship you. We join the thousands of thousands upon thousands upon thousands upon thousands upon thousands upon thousands upon thousands of angels. We say you are holy. We say you are holy. We say you are holy. As long as we have breath, we will say you are holy. The dead cannot praise you this morning, Lord. We have breath. So we say you are holy. We worship you, oh Father. We honor you, Father. We love you, Father. We say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, O Lamb of God, who is seated on the throne this morning and who is interceding and fighting for us. We thank you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, hallelujah. God bless you, hallelujah. I want to welcome all of you to the house of God this morning, amen. We extend a right hand of fellowship to all of you that are watching us on the various social media platforms. Thank you. Please make time to come and join us because this is the epicenter of the divine action for the glory of God. God bless all of you. Let's look unto the Lord in prayer. Everlasting Father and God, we thank you. We bless you. Ancient of Days, we worship your holy name. We exalt and ascribe glory and praise and an adoration to your majestic holy name. Thank you, Jesus, for this place, mighty God, of your dwelling, that you have gathered us, mighty God, to speak your words of healing and hope and victory and breakthrough into our lives. We thank you in Jesus' mighty name, because nobody comes to you and walk away empty-handed. We thank you, Father God, in Jesus' name. Our gathering was deliberately mighty God purpose, as you singled us out individually by grace, mighty God, to come and sit in the cozy comfort of your divine presence and for you to speak hope, healing, victory into our lives. We honor you and adore you. Be exalted in Jesus' name. We pray out every device of the enemy, every attack of the devil, mighty God. Anything that will seek to distract or to steal our attention, mighty God. We overcome it, mighty God. Fill the space with your glory. Arrest all receptive faculties, mighty God. And Father God, in Jesus' name, inspire the rewarding words of faith and comfort for your people. In the end, Father God, in Jesus' name, we know that our lives will never be the same. We bless and glorify you in Jesus' name. Amen. Please lift up your sword. Wave it in the air. Put a shivers on the devil. Let the enemy know you are armed and very. Please permit me. Let me take a sip. My voice is hoarse. I don't know. Lord, praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Amen. Amen. With such a powerful worship, why wouldn't my voice be hoarse? Amen. Glory be to God. We take it by force. Amen.
Amen.
So please, let's look at the word of God this morning. Exodus chapter 16. We'll read from verse 14 to 21. Exodus chapter 16, reading from verse 14 to 21. It's also on the monitor. You can read with us. And when the layer of dew lifted up, there on the surface of the wilderness was a small round substance, as fine as a frost on the ground. So when the children of Israel saw it, they said to one another, "What is it?" And they didn't know what it was. And Moses said to them, "This is the bread which the Lord has given to you to eat. This is the thing which the Lord has commanded. Let every man gather it according to each one's need. One omer for each person, according to the number of persons. Let every man take for those who are in his tent." Then the children of Israel did so and gathered, some more, some less. So when they measured it by omers, he who gathered much had nothing left over, and he who gathered little had no lack. Every man had gathered according to each one's need. And Moses said, "Let no one leave anything of it till morning." Notwithstanding, they did not heed Moses, but some of them left part of it until morning, and it bred worms and stank, and Moses was angry with them. So they gathered it every morning, every man according to his need, and when the sun became hot, it melted. Please be seated. I'm speaking this morning on the subject guaranteed portion. Hallelujah. Amen. Say guaranteed portion. Glory be to God. We have to understand that God Almighty is the source. And I may sound like a simpleton trying to get this message across. Because everyone who believes in God and those who don't believe know that God is the source of it all. But sometimes we have to remind people, because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, that God is still in the place of releasing the best. James chapter 1 verse 16 and 17 says, "Do not be deceived. For every good and perfect gift come from above, from the Father of all lights." And when we say Father, that also connotes an idea. There's only space that God is. Abba Father is not just Abba Father, the way we relate to Him. Amen? In fact, in the Aramaic is Abba Father. In the Hebrew is Avinu. Shema Shemayim. My God, the God of heaven and earth. Through Him all blessings flow. And you got the chance to call Him Father. Because of three dimensions that only He represents in our lives. He's the source of it all. He's the sustainer of it all. And He's also what? The supplier. He told Moses, "The name that I revealed to Abraham, the name is," when he sent Moses, he said, "The name that I'm sending you, I didn't reveal to the fathers. He was sending him the name. This name I didn't reveal to the fathers. But He revealed Himself to them in a different way, according to the need of the time. There were 10 dwellers and there were few. So He revealed Himself, Genesis 17:1, as El Shaddai, the all-sufficient God. They were few, but they were sufficiently provided. Look at Abraham's audacity, wanting to buy a land. The man said, "I give the land to you for free." When you read in Genesis chapter 23, the sons of Heth. Abraham said, no, I still want to pay. The guy actually stiff him, right? Because the thing is, he tells you that the man didn't want to give the land for free. Because if you want to give someone something for free, the persons I want to buy, why do you even mention the price of the thing? Oh, take it. It is nothing. It's just 400 pieces of silver. But I say, take it. The man was waiting to hear the price. But we didn't hear no when Abraham counted the money for him. He took it. Later on, Abraham was able to tell the king of Sodom, so that you don't go and tell people that I made Abraham rich. That was one aspect. We have this relationship as Father. When we look at this scripture, it is also one of the classics that I've often emphasized in this church. The law of first use. When God himself decides, without you praying for him, because the point is, who can even let on, will come to the name. God decided, this is what I'm going to do. For 40 years, if anybody has said, anybody says, I'm going to take care of you for 40 years, people, you have, are you insane? 40 years. Millions of people and their dependents. 40 years. And that was the law of first use. Israel didn't pray for him to bring bread or nothing, but he decided, this is what I'm going to do. He said, to test them whether they will believe me when I feed them. And he wasn't going to ask, have a deal with worms to bring the bread that they are going to throw away, bring it to let me supply to my people. The Bible says, Psalm 78 verse 24, Israel ate the food of angels. Angelic chairs prepare their meals. Every morning they wake up and the food is there. And God is so caring, like every parent. Sometimes you don't want your children to eat food that is left over, because you are going to prepare something new. Even when the child is a youth, no, don't eat it. Hallelujah. He said, don't leave none behind. Whatever I give, eat. For tomorrow, you are assured. Tell somebody, hallelujah. Your tomorrow is assured. Now the reason the Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 6, do not worry about tomorrow. Hallelujah. What you eat, what you do not worry. The Bible says it is the pagan. A pagan doesn't have a father like you have, who is in the place of the source of all goodness, who is in the place of absolute sublime surprise. He will supply Ephesians chapter 3:20, is able to supply exceedingly, abundantly, beyond all that you can ever ask or think. Is it Uncle Sam can do that? Can Uncle Sam match that? Exceedingly, abundantly. You ask him for a cup full, he says, that's why he says, he will open the floodgates of heaven and pour blessings. That will have room. We won't have room enough to contain what he's bringing. Tell some, are you ready for this? Exceedingly abundantly supply. He says, I am your source. You don't have to look outside me for anything. Once something asks me. Hallelujah. Some of you parents don't sometimes. I remember when I was little. And I go to the neighbor's house and I eat. My mom gets so mad. I was little and I said, why is she angry? Hallelujah. So I get some. Hallelujah. One of my favorite authors, word, Wole Soyinka. Amen. I got what is called the admonitory wax. Quoting Wole Soyinka. Amen. Never go to that house to go and eat. There's food in this house. Now you see what I mean. Your father is able. He doesn't want you to go to any house. Come to his house. Oh. Come to your father's house to come and eat. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So God said, this is what I'm going to do. Food of angels. I'm going to cook something special. Sometimes when you go somewhere and you eat, you know, sometimes people, especially ladies who understand, my sister Gwen is still laughing, amen. Never ask a woman for her recipe. Somebody told me. Only a man said yes, I didn't. Hallelujah. A woman invites you to come and eat, go eat all you can, take some left, you know, get some takeaway, amen. But don't go and be praying for something. Can I get the recipe? Hallelujah. Sometimes they get offended for doing that, for you asking them. If you want another meal, you ask, I will cook for you. Hallelujah. Don't ask me what to put in there and whatever. Hallelujah. You come and eat, but don't ask. God kept his recipe secret. Oh, hallelujah. Amen. You see? So the sisters are not sharing because father didn't share. Glory. So the people were enjoying it. But one thing is that God was doing a good thing. He reigned for all. But you know, people will always be people. God said, take, go, everybody go and eat free. He gave freely. Bible said, freely you have received, freely give. But somebody will bring greed in there. I mean, how much can you eat? Some people went there and gathered. And they didn't think about next door neighbor. They didn't think about their sisters or brothers. They didn't think that these people have children. They gathered all, more, and took it to their home. When others showed up, there were a few left. Hallelujah. Amen. Tell somebody you are always guaranteed your portion. The race is never to the swift. So someone will be fast to go and gather. And you will be slow. And you go and there's nothing left. Hallelujah. Amen. Your portion is guaranteed. Glory be to God. It doesn't matter who ran far, Hussein Bolt. You set a record. Gathered everything. Hussein has taken it all. Amen. The Bible says those who gathered much because of their greediness, thinking about themselves, all these people were marching for one goal. Then the point is this. There's a place they say one man no eat. So when you are gathering, don't you even think in your mind that you have your fellow marchers with you. The old philosophy said a soldier marches on his stomach. They need a full stomach to march. And you went and gathered because you are only thinking about yourself and your family. God is not worshipped in such ways. God is not served in such ways. Philippians 2:4 says that even when you go to pray, do not pray only for yourself, but pray for others. Because you know a thing or two of what someone else is going through. You know a thing or two of some brother's burden or some sister's burden. What some parents are struggling going through. Have that at the back of your mind. Don't come and gather it all and scoop it and go away. So the Bible says when they took it to their rooms, those who gathered much and those who gathered less, God is a God of equalization. Hallelujah. Amen. He's an equilibrium God. He brought equilibrium. Hallelujah. You gathered much. No, I give you according to your need. Listen to the word. My God will supply. Yeah? All your need. He gives you according to your need, not according to your greed. The principle is according to your need, not according to your greed. So he gave according to what you need. Because tomorrow you are guaranteed. Another portion, amen, whether you are late or whether you are fast, your portion still comes to you the same. Tell somebody none is left behind. None. If you are watching us, you are not left behind. If you are in-house, you are never left behind. In the economy of God, everybody is guaranteed a portion. A portion of favor, a portion of grace, a portion of breakthrough, a portion of prosperity, a portion of divine protection and provision and peace in your life. Your portion is yours. If even someone greedily takes it, God will reverse it and come to you. Because one thing you have to understand, the thing was sent miraculously. Hallelujah. Amen. It didn't come from anybody's bakery. Amen. They say it in French, boulangerie. Boulangerie à la abla. Amen. Glory be to God. Abla boulangerie. Hallelujah. It comes from God. So nobody can bring the greed factor in them. But the earth, and the Bible says, until they reach. Oh, talk to me, people. Verse 35 says, until they reach the border of the Jordan and they cross over. Glory be to God. And the manna stopped 40 years. They never starved. They were never malnourished. God gave them the best of food, but the point is this. They were eating, but they still didn't know what they were eating. They called it manna. Look at your life. What do you think has sustained you? You think your job? You think your career? There are things going on in your life you have no idea. It is the manna. Jesus says, I am the manna from heaven. In John chapter 6, says, your fathers ate something they didn't know. That is why they call it manna. Manna means, what is this? What is this? Isn't everything from God a mystery? You are asking, what is it? And your people around you, your family is even asking you, what is this? How come you survived this? How come you are still alive? I remember, because when I was growing up, I was always sick. And one of my aunties hasn't seen me in a long time. So one day he bumped into me and said, hey, are you still alive? Yeah, I'm alive. I'm not dead, auntie. I'm still around. There are things that people even look at you and say, what is this? Because they never thought. Yeah. Hallelujah. So if we go by the principle that even what we eat to live, you are what is it in the eyes of people because of what you are eating every day. Talk to me. These are people who don't farm. They have no land even to farm. And yet they were eating well. Hallelujah. What did they know? Sometimes when you are down and out and you think everything is upside down, don't forget this. Because the Bible says every day there was something new, a portion. I'm here to assure you, every day that you call a difficult day, a challenging day, a day of problems, God has your portion ready for. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Say, shout guaranteed. I say, shout guaranteed. Thank you, miracle. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory, I think the message is for her. Praise the name of Jesus. People may be attacking you. People may be saying things about you. But they don't even know why you keep on keeping on. Because every day God has purpose. That there is some guaranteed grace to come your way. Guaranteed blessing to come your way. Guaranteed sustenance to keep you through. People sometimes, how do you make it? I can't explain. Because if I'm surviving by burrito, I can tell you burrito is keeping me alive. If I'm surviving by chicken quesadilla, then quesadilla is keeping me eating something and it's giving me something that is called something I can't explain. Don't ask me any questions. Hallelujah. Because I wake up and it is there. Every morning it is new. But Jesus said, the one who did it before is able to do it again. Oh, talk to me. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory be to God. If he has done it before, then he can also what? Do it again. And it's not faced by the numbers. So he says, every morning, because that is his method. Hallelujah. Amen. Every morning. Now, those who bake bread, they wake up early in the morning and they bake their bread. They deliver it very hot. Hallelujah. Glory be to God who put it in your mouth and it is melting. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Now, some of you donut aficionados, those who love donuts, right? Early in the morning, blocking traffic. Oh, hallelujah. Glory be to God. There's a street going to the LAX. You don't want to pass there in the morning. Don't leave house late. Trying to say, I'm going to the airport. I'm cutting a flight. And you pass there. You'll miss your flight. I think most people miss their flight when they take that road. There's a donut shop that's been there since Methuselah. Hallelujah. That small donut shop, they haven't done any refurbishment and everything. It says Methuselah. The painting is still the same. Hallelujah. But do you care for anything colorful? It is what comes from inside. It's not what is showing on the outside. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. You use that route, you will never land in Kotoka, I tell you. God, hallelujah. Amen. So every morning, and Jesus says, ask your Father every morning. My Father, who has done it before, and can also do it again. Amen. I don't know why I'm sounding Frenchy this morning. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Yeah. Say repete. That is French. Amen. He had done it before and he can also what? Repeat it. He can also repeat it. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen. He has done it before and he can repeat it. So Jesus says, every morning, Israel didn't see his face, but he delivered to them. At their address, at their doorstep, he know the zip code. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory be to God. Every morning when you wake up, ask him, my Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, daddy. Give me this day, my daily, oh, talk to me, people. Amen. My daily bread. Hallelujah. Your sustenance for the day. You may not know how. You may not know when. But you will never sleep hungry. It may be the most difficult day. Hallelujah. Hell is broken loose. But you don't know how you are going to go through the day. Glory be to God. Because when heavens open, God pours plenty. Glory be to God. Every day, says every day, ask. My brothers and sisters, guaranteed portion. Jesus says in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 24, when he used his body, he says, your fathers ate the manna, but they still died in the wilderness. They didn't die because of the man. They died because of their own choices. When they tempted God, and God in Numbers chapter 14, 22 says, these people have tempted me these 10 times. He sent them to go and spy on the land and bring a report. They came, the report that they gave is exactly as God said. There's a scripture in the book of Proverbs. He said, too much talking, mistakes, is never far away from talking too much. Some of you do talk, and then you forget that this is Instagram age. People can have you on camera. I didn't say that. Wallahi talahi, you say, hey, this is the video. Peter, there you are, swearing before a maid servant. Me, I never know this man. From Adam, I don't know him. Why are you blaming me, young woman? This is your video, Peter. Too much talking. You came, you have brought evidence, that is enough. Every battle, and it took battles to bring you this far. Like everybody's journey, it's never been smooth sailing. You battle against everything in life. That sometimes people wonder how you are even alive. Your doctor sees it, you are a miracle. Sometimes some of you don't even know. Your doctors envy you. They've seen so many terrible things about you, but when you walk to the office and say, ah, this woman. Sometimes they don't know medication to give. Some of them are even shy to ask you what you have, to share your manner with them. I have a daughter who went for a routine, you know, medical checkup. And the doctor, you know, did this thing, the gynecologist checked, examined her because she couldn't have a child. Because some time ago, in another country, in a third world country, she got pregnant. And it was ectopic, so it messed one of the fallopian tubes. They did some, you know, third world surgery. Amen. She ended up with a third world, you know, reproduction system. Hallelujah. A patchwork. Amen. Hallelujah. Because there you don't have Kaiser, you don't have Medicare, Obamacare. Hallelujah. Everybody is one plan. Amen. God is our Savior. I tell you, we have survived by the grace of God. Amen. Hallelujah. You cannot go and say, hey, this is my plan. What plan? Better pray that the medicine is even available. We'll go and talk about it. So she went, you know, and the doctor said, "Yo," showed her on the screen. Said, "This is how your uterus is. The uterus is like a soccer ball that had been left in there." The guys, honest, soccer ball that had been, you know, is no more in use. It's been left outside. And rain has beaten on it. The sun has gone through all the vagaries. It's seen winter, it's seen summer, it's seen all the weather. That's how the uterus was looking at. All weather, you know, leather. He said, we have to take the thing out because you can never have a child with it. The woman walked away from Kaiser on La Cienega, Cadillac, crying to my office, weeping. Pastor, the doctor said this, going to take my uterus and throw it away. I said, ah, how do you throw something you didn't give? You believe God can? You say yes. So we prayed. God is good. Hallelujah. This is a manna-eating sister. And you are going to take her uterus away? There's life in the manna. So, I prayed for her. And then, you know, she and her husband started regularly. 3 months later, the sister became pregnant. Nobody in this church history has tormented me with pregnancy like this woman. Because of her previous ectopic thing, even when she's having morning sickness, she thinks some demons are coming, attacking her. Pastor, pray for me. By the grace of God, she carried full term. And guess what was the doctor on duty to deliver her? Doctor, take it out. Amen. God says, since you love taking things out, I'm going to give you a jar to take something out. This, amen. So doctor, take it out, showed up. Amen. And then, the lady was lying there, and then the baby was coming. He said, doctor, do you remember me? He said, pastor, in my pain, I mustered courage. He says, doctor, do you remember me? I said, no. He said, yeah, yeah. Can you refresh my memory? He said, I'm the one that was said that my uterus is useless. We have to throw it away. The man said, oh, but how come you got pregnant? Says, I went to church. Hey! I went to church and my pastor prayed for me and I'm pregnant. So now, daughter, you're on duty. Hallelujah. Deliver the bouncing baby girl. And he comes and says, Pastor, I want you to give a name to this child. I say, her name is Emanuela. Emanuela. Now today, Emanuela wants to be a doctor too. Not to take other people's uterus out, amen, but to give it life. Lay hands when it needed in Jesus' mighty name. My brothers and sisters, as I sum up, the race is not to the swift. Whoever got ahead of you, no. Whoever seems to have gotten ahead of you, do not panic. Because your portion is guaranteed. Tell somebody your portion is guaranteed. The ones who gather much, those who gather little, there is equilibrium in God. Hallelujah. Get ready for yours, amen. Hallelujah. Somebody may run ahead of you. Amen. Your portion will not run away from you. Some people may run away, but your portion guaranteed is not running away from you. Hallelujah. It will definitely come to you. Rise up and bless the name of Jesus this morning. Exalt the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. We praise you, Jesus. We honor you, Jesus. We glorify your holy name. Thank you so much for your gracious words of assurance. We are always guaranteed your blessed portion in Jesus' name. We are always guaranteed your blessed goodness in the name of the Lord Jesus. It doesn't matter who seemed to have gotten ahead. Hallelujah. Our portion remains ours. You always remember God of equilibrium, and you bring give us ours. We praise you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We glorify you. Anybody watching us who is in need, who seem to be dealing with delays in their lives, mighty God, and think God has forgotten and forsaken them, hallelujah. Your portion still remains, and it will be yours. For some, they gather them at their outside. Some, for some, it was presented to them in their rooms. Get ready, it's coming to your room. God knows the address. I pray for favor upon your people. In Jesus' name, amen. And please, if you are watching us and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I'm sorry, my voice. Please, join me as we say the salvation prayers together. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I'm truly sorry for all my sins. And I ask Jesus to forgive me. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord and Savior. With all my heart, I confess that Christ alone is the only begotten Son of God, and that he who knew no sin took my place on the cross. Jesus died for me. He rose again on the third day and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Thank you, Jesus, that I'm born again and I'm saved by grace. Everlasting Father and God and King, I thank you. I bless and glorify you in Jesus' name. I praise you for your people, mighty God, for their faith expressed in you. God, direct them, mighty God, to places in the kingdom that you've already marked for them to be nourished and sublimely nurtured with the truth that they'll grow thereby for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Please be seated. If you are watching us, and please, if you responded to this altar call, if you are watching us from a distant place, I encourage you to look for a Bible teaching church to go and worship, a place where they teach sound doctrine, to go and worship the living God. Amen. Otherwise, you can't call us. We are one church in 6 places here in California. Amen. Look at the addresses. And if you happen to be living in close proximity to any of these addresses, We invite you to bring your friends and family, those in your immediate circumference and close associates, to come to worship with us. Amen. But if you are watching us from another city, another state, another town, maybe another country even, we have a network of churches within the U.S. and also outside. Please, you can call us and we can help you locate a place where you can go and worship and be fed, and you can call it home. God bless you very, very much. Amen. Praise God. Now it's time for us to come and worship the Lord with our substance. Our church has no source of funding except what you give out of your free will volition. We don't superimpose, we don't coerce. Amen. But we just do what the Bible says. Your first fruit, your tithe, special offerings, special donations. These are ways of giving. You can see on the monitor. Amen. You can test your giving. You can cash up your giving. You can also give online. Amen. Or if you are in the house, amen, you can pay a visit to Pastor Emmanuel, maybe swipe your debit and credit and be a blessing. Or there are envelopes behind the church. You can pick one, put in your seed, tithes and offering. Make sure you write your name and your current address, make it more legible. Amen. Shall we all rise up and let's welcome our pastor, Pastor Nana, to come and receive our tithes and offering. For let's put our hands together for the man of God as he comes.
Amen and amen. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for what has come this morning. We give all the praise and all the glory and all the adoration. We thank you for your goodness, your grace, and your mercy, mighty God. We thank you, mighty God, for this morning as we come before your presence to bring our offering, our tithe unto you, mighty God. As I open up the heavens and pour a blessing upon us, mighty God. We thank you how far you have brought us, mighty God. Let it be a season of laughter and joy for your people, mighty God. Because the Bible said in manna was the one that sustained the children of Israel throughout the wilderness, mighty God. He kept them, you protected them, mighty God. We thank you for the word, mighty God, that has bring forth power in our life, mighty God. We thank you, we bless you, Lord. We give all the praise and all the glory and all the adoration. Let us just say amen and amen. Amen.
To 6 a.m. Mondays through Fridays, and come back from 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. for our evening prayer session to conclude your day. Please see the screen for the number.
You deserve the praise. Worthy is your name.
Join us every Monday night, 7 p.m. sharp, for our young adults class. God is pouring so much wisdom and knowledge into us through His servant, Apostle Dr. Vincent Okosa. This class will fill you with so many pointers on life skills, and you can't say no to that.
Calling all kingdom marriages. Join Apostle and Pastor Mary the last Monday of each month at 7 p.m. on Zoom for our new couple seminar called Love Rekindled. You can send in your anonymous questions to be answered. Let's build the kingdom starting first at home. Let's contend for powerful, strong kingdom marriages.
God's word is a lamp to guide our feet and a light for our path. Join us every Wednesday night at 7 p.m. for our Bible study Q&A. It's a time we come together to glorify God through fellowship with one another and to study the word of God.
He picks us up, He turns us around, and He places our feet on solid ground. We thank the Master, we thank our Savior, and we thank God. Please tune in for our prayer and prophecy night on Fridays at 7 p.m. and watch the move of the Holy Spirit. Our pastor will pray over individual prayer requests and proclaiming the infallible word of our Lord.
Let all the other names fade away.
Praises go up, blessings come down. Let's come together and worship and praise our great God every Sunday at 10 a.m. at our Pomona campus, and come be our special guest.
Come on, be enthroned on our praise.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. This is for the children's ministry, right?
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. On behalf of Miss Mary Beth, amen. Praise God. And Jeannie, amen. Miss Jeannie, amen. Miss Eka in absentia, and Mrs. Corsa, amen. On maternity leave, amen. Mrs. Bolt, Hallelujah. All the misses that are helping, taking care of the children's ministry, except one miss, a Miss Mary Beth. Let's put our hands together for all the work. Amen. They have raised 210. Amen. This is for the VPS Vacation Bible Study for the children. Amen. So when the children come home for the long vacation during summer, amen, parents who can bring the children, the teachers will work out the arrangement, and then they teach the children Bible stories. Amen. So thank you so much. But please don't see 210 and say it's enough. Amen. Some of you can also come and support them. Amen. Maybe you go to Costco. You can talk to the teachers. Don't just buy anything. Talk to them. They know what they want. You can bring some supplies to come and help in that effort. So we thank God. God bless all of you for your support. Amen. Amen. The women's Women's Awareness is coming. Amen. April 20th. Next week. Amen. Hallelujah. Saturday, April 20th, 11 a.m. This is Zoom, so you can be everywhere. You can even be in Ouagadougou, amen, and still tune in. Amen. So please, this is Women's Health Awareness Part 2. Amen. And God is using local, talents, amen, resources, women in Christ Citadel, amen, who God has gifted, blessed, working, in higher position in the medical field to speak to women. Amen. Please, I make a law. If you are a man, stay far, 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 far away. Amen. Hallelujah. Let the women, don't say I called him by mistake. It is women. Hallelujah. Read my lips. It is what? Women. Stay far away, a million miles away. Let the women do their women talk. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm looking at you, Godwin. I know you love Zoom. Stay far away from it. Amen. So it's the women, amen, and God have blessed us. Amen. These are the ladies. Mrs. Susanna Numo is the first lady of our church in San Fernando campus. Amen. Amen. She works at Cedars. Amen. Mrs. Kate Wharton, a nutritionist. Kate was a nurse. Amen. At Kaiser Sunset for many years. Amen. So she is now into nutritional stuff. So she'll bring her nutritional knowledge. Deaconess Karen Mensah, she works at UCLA. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. She's also in the San Fernando Valley Church. I know last year it was our sister Esther. Amen. And Mrs. Sampson. Amen. And other people who participated in this. Hallelujah. So these ladies, please join in. It's Zoom, so you have no excuse. 11 a.m. on the 20th. Tune in and have this women's thing going. God bless you so much. Amen. Praise God. Financial Growth Seminar. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Young adults. Amen. Are young adults in the house? I didn't. Hallelujah. You see, please, this is financial growth seminar. Amen. When it comes to finances, though the young adults are bringing the seminar here, but everybody needs some kudi in your pocket. Amen. Oh, you didn't hear what I said. Though it's the young adults that are bringing the seminar, that everybody needs some kudi in your pocket, right? Who doesn't need money? So please, men, this is also Zoom. Amen. Tune in. We are bringing, we want to thank God, the host, Dr. Pastor Elvis Sampson, president of the Young Adults. And these are the men and the women that are going to talk to us. Amen. Senior Elder Kafui Mensah of our San Fernando Valley Church. You saw his wife. Amen. Karen. Amen. He's a CPA, AVP, he's a vice president of an investment accounting firm, Zenith Insurance, amen, in the valley. He's coming to give us a talk about the money. We also want to applaud our resident pastor, Pastor Emmanuel, who have been doing this I think two sessions, amen, with the young adults. Hallelujah. No wonder they are loaded like that. Amen. I didn't get an amen when I say loaded. Doctor, is it High Mind? What's the name? Hamid? Okay. Dr. High Mind Pointer. Himidi. Dr. Himidi Pointer. Amen. Hallelujah. Our own brother, Derek Ablin. If you want to buy a house, call Derek. Amen. Hallelujah. He started, rested. It didn't take long. He became the worker of the year or something. So contact him. Amen. He'll be coming to talk to you how you can own a house. Amen. You better buy some houses. Dr. Kwia Mankwa, amen. Associate professor, amen. Who is also a cousin to Dr. Winifred Sampson. Amen. Mr. Godfred Ahianyo, amen. These are the people that are coming to give us a talk about when it comes to money, you cannot get enough lessons about money. So tune in, amen, and learn how to save your money. Don't say, God, I'm poor, amen. If you are blowing your money like an Epicurean, how are you going to save? Some of you don't know how to save, amen. So join in this, and you also have to set some money aside, retirement and all those things. They are coming to teach you. God bless you so much. We applaud your leadership, President Elvis, amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Also, I want to put you on speed. June 1st. June 8th. Oh. Okay. Thank God. Hallelujah. June 8th instead of 1st. Put on your dancing shoes. Amen. All roads lead to Christ Citadel Pomona. We are having a powerful praise and worship concert. Amen. You are not excited about it. June 8th, 6 p.m. Amen. Hallelujah. Come join us. We are having a powerful, amen. I'm glad you changed the date. Because there was a conflict. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen. Our own one of us. Amen. Dr. Wanda. Hallelujah. That's a day. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the name. So you are moving to the 8th. Amen. Anyway, praise God. Anyway, on this note, any celebrants in the house? Celebrants? Okay. I want to recognize a lady that I've known. Her husband is best friend with my big brother. Amen. Hallelujah. And I met her a long time ago. Maybe she may not recall. I'm the one who officiated your son's wedding, Uriah's wedding in Los Angeles. Amen. So I want to recognize Mrs. Rosemensa. Please. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming. And you know, she went to her brother Sunday's shop. And Sunday mentioned this church. That's why she found it. So Sunday, if you are watching, thank you so much. Hallelujah. Thank you, Mrs. Mensa. God bless you very much. Hallelujah. No celebrants. Don't waste your songs then. And nobody's. Hallelujah. Maybe Gordon will dance to it because I think it's every Sunday is his birthday. Amen. Hallelujah. God bless all of you and thank you. Amen. Let us all stand up, praise God, and receive the benediction. Almighty God and King, we thank you. We bless you so much. Praise you, Father God, in Jesus' name, for the outpouring of your blessings upon us. Thank you, Father God, for bringing us to come and sit at the comfort of your presence and to receive your word. We praise you, we bless you, we glorify and trust your people into your gracious care. Now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord cause his face to shine on you and be gracious unto you. The everlasting Father, gracious countenance on you and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, be blessed, remain blessed. Shalom in Jesus' name. Amen. Please, if you have your tithe, step forward. Let us pray for you. Step forward with your tithe, please.